You asked me where I was born.
Yeah.
New Berlin, New York.
New Berlin, yeah.
And I grew up 10 miles below in South New Berlin.
Uh-huh.
And I built a home in Mount Upton, that's another 10 miles below South New Berlin.
Huh. And why did you come to this area?
To build the 500 fireplaces at Roxbury Run condominiums.
Wow.
So I built 109 and they all quit.
109?
I built 102 in every condominium.
So you're a stonemason?
Then I won't go right next door and do no one.
But I thought you were going to do 500, but you only did 110. You did 109?
Yeah.
But you were going to
I built 60 for Lou Kohler and Stan Migdo. And they quit.
They quit.
Landmark Corporation suffering took over, and I built 49 for them, and they were sons of bitches.
So you
terrible,
had enough.
Terrible people. Especially the superintendent.
Okay. And then you had enough.
Huh?
You stopped.
Yeah, and they quit.
They quit too.
So, yeah, that's all kind of made were built.
So they didn't do all 500?
No.
Okay.
No.
So but what when you say you built the fireplace, you do the stonework or what?
Yeah. I'm a stone man.
Uh-huh. Where did you learn that?
Well, I went to Delhi and graduated in 1951, right in the Air Force. But I took building construction in Delhi.
Uh-huh. And where did you learn to trap?
Here and there, ever since I was 12 years old. Muskrats on the Unadilla River.
Uh-huh.
And the farmer on top of the hill that hauled our milk from the farm bought fur. If I had a couple of muskrats, I'd run out and wave at him. He stopped. Back then, I was getting 3 1/4 for a muskrat. That was good money back in them days.
$3?
$3 1/4.
Uh-huh. Back then, way back then.
Yeah.
So, what about fishers? Did you ever catch a fisher?
Yeah, Louie and I got. 15 2 years ago,
wow.
And just a half a dozen last year. Poor trapping, no market. Huh. We didn't do much.
How about beavers?
The weather was terrible. Huh?
The beavers, do you get beavers?
Yeah. We get quite a few.
And what do you do with them when you get them?
Skin them.
Yeah.
Then take the pad off, let them dry on a board.
And then what?
Then we sell them.
To who?
Fur buyer.
Yeah. Wow.
What are you doing, recording all that?
Yeah, I'll show you. Wait, here.
Yeah. Grumpy old man.
Yeah.
No, that's when they all get together and buy traps and lures and baits.
Uh-huh.
And stuff.
What kind of traps do you use?
Well, one called the conner bear and the other's a leg hole trap.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. We use both. The conner bear is deadly. They stick their head in there, hit them whiskers, it closes up on them, and they're dead immediately.
Well, and
very
about,
humane.
Uh-huh. And what about the leg traps?
Well, you get there before they get away or whatever, and then shoot them or cold cock them or something. Yeah.
Did you ever get yourself caught in a trap?
Yeah. I had to have my boy come help get it off my boot strap.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, gosh.
I couldn't get it alone.
Really?
The beaver trap is big.
Did it hurt your leg?
No, it caught my boot strap.
It was on your boot strap.
Yeah, my hold my
wow.
Leg, or my
your pants.
Boot strap.
Oh my God.
Just a strap.
Wow. You must have had strong straps.
Yeah.
You didn't want to take out a knife
they
and
are
cut
strong.
It? Huh. Wow.
A hair spill.
A bricklayer?
Yeah, union.
A union bricklayer?
Yeah.
Wow.
I never got a pension because I was in and out so many times.
Oh, so you didn't get any pension?
And I got drifted into doing a lot of stone work.
Did you get any Social Security?
Yeah, I get that.
Yeah.
I'd be dead if I didn't have that.
So how did you learn stonework?
Just pick it up as I went along.
Uh-huh. But who would pick out the stones for you?
Myself.
Really?
Yeah.
Where would you get the stones from?
Different farmers around along the road.
Uh-huh.
All over.
Would you use bluestone or round stones?
No, regular stones like that on the wall.
Uh-huh. Wow. And what, you'd use cement to put it, to
yeah.
put the fireplace together?
Yeah.
Wow. Would you put in heat-elators?
I did, but
yeah.
Don't do it anymore because they rust out.
They what?
They rust. They
really?
Get wet. They uh-huh. get rusty.
From all the moisture in the fire. Yeah. So heat-elators aren't any good. Oh.
No. Because you got hot, cold there, but if they get moisture over years, they're no good.
Wow.
And I then, didn't see how they're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just come from there.
I had to deal with him for 3 days.
How much perch did you catch?
A lot. Oh,
probably 75 or 80.
They left a lot at your
beach.
Last year we had 100. Huh? Years before what we beach? Probably had over 100.
We went to the little bridge there on the backside, Gilman Town Road. On, you go down on the backside and it goes inside the swamp like that.
Oh.
Huh?
Not the road that goes around the lake?
You know Speculator?
Around the lake.
Yeah.
Lake Pleasant?
Yeah. Well, the road that goes around the lake and the bridge there?
Yeah.
That's called Cherry Beach, I think.
Okay, that's what it is.
You've been up there before, huh?
Yeah.
She grew up there.
Beach every day.
She only went there once, Francis.
And I didn't leave with potatoes.
That's a heart-shaped potato? Let me see it.
I was thinking if I made a box of just heart-shaped potatoes, that'd be worth double.
Oh, triple.
Francis?
What?
Are you going to start digging potatoes?
No, I like what I'm doing.
How come you don't use a fork?
You want me to dig potatoes? I said, no, I like what I'm doing.
Yeah, no. Mulch.
You going to eat those?
This field is loaded with dandelions.
You know you can dry this and grind it and make tea, right?
Coffee.
You roast it?
Chicory. It's like chicory, yeah.
I was reading and this woman would detail everything that she did every day in like the 1800s. And she said that she was like sewing and burned coffee. It's like burned coffee? What does that mean? Burning, roasting dandelions?
Beautiful, wow.
He cooked them.
So do you cook the greens, Louis?
Yeah, cook the leaves.
Uh-huh.
You put vinegar and butter with them.
Wow.
What I always did. Give it a taste.